Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about water distribution system. Myself Manoj Patil, assistant professor in civil engineering department, MEP's KBT COE, NASE. See student, in this lecture we are discuss about the introduction of the water distribution system, then the various components of water distribution system, then the basic requirements of the water distribution system, then the objectives of the good distribution system, then the methods of distribution of water, then the layouts of pipe network. Various layouts of pipe networks are there, like radial system, dead end system, that we are discuss in this lecture. Okay, then the water supply system, then the comparison between the continuous and intermediate system, then the storage reservoir, and lastly classification of the storage reservoir, that we are discuss in this lecture. So see, first one is the introduction of the water distribution system. See student, distribution of the water is the last phase of any water supply scheme. After completing the all the treatment of the water, water is supplied to the people through the pipeline or through the network of the water carrying system. Through that, water is supplied to the people. See, the function of the distribution system is to furnish the treated water in required quantity, maintaining its quality under required pressure whenever, wherever it is needed, in the city or in the town. Okay. See, after the purification, that water is supplied through the pipeline, okay, to the individual house, okay, or to the industrial unit, or to the public places, okay. See, this consumption of water may be residential, industrial, commercial, or public purpose, okay. So, in this way, that water is supplied to the various purposes. Now see, components of distribution system. See, this distribution system consists of number of components, like the network of pipes, which are to be comprising of mains, submains, branches, feeders, and laterals. Okay, then the valves for controlling the flow in the pipe. Okay, for the control of the flow. Okay, there are different types of valves are used in the water distribution system. Then the fire hydrants, okay, service connection, water meters, distribution service reservoir, okay, that then the pump. There are various types of pumps are also used for water distribution in the water distribution system. Okay, so these are the various components of the water distribution systems are there. Okay. See, on the basis of the topography of the region and road network, okay, the water distribution system is to be prepared. Okay, and while preparing such type of plan, all the details about the location of the pump and pumping station, balancing reservoir, position of the wall, street mains, and the hydrant, that must be marked, okay, to have the correct execution of the plan. Okay. So these are the various components of the water distribution systems are there. Next one is the, what are the basic requirement of the good water distribution system? See, first one is the quality of water must be maintained. Okay, I mean, whatever the distribution system is there, that should maintain the quality of water. That distribution system should not be, there should not any leakage, so that that water may get contaminated. So first point, first requirement is the quality of water must be maintained in the water distribution system. Then second one is the, each consumer must get required quantity of water with the desired pressure, so that every consumer can get the sufficient quantity of water. Okay, so that consumer should get the required quantity and with required pressure. Then third one is the distribution system must be economical. It should not be so much costly. Okay, their maintenance cost should be less. Then the adequate water must be made available to put out an emergency. So if there is, suppose fire is occur, so there should be sufficient quantity of water is available during the emergency. Then the repairing work of the distribution system should not cause obstruction to the road traffic. So these are the some basic requirement of good distribution systems are there. Okay. Next point is the what are the objective of the good distribution systems? See, the water distribution system is designed with the following objective. First one, that it must convey the water to the point of need from the treatment plant. Then it must maintain the quality of water from the plant to the actual user, to the actual consumer. Okay. Then the good distribution system must ensure the supply of water with sufficient pressure and quantity at all the places during all the time. So every person gets sufficient quantity of water. Then good distribution system must have the arrangement to provide water to meet the emergency like fire. Okay. And that water distribution, good distribution system must be reliable service. So these are the some objective of the good water distribution system. Now next point is the very important point, that the methods of distributing water. See, depending upon the nature, topography between the source and the consumer, okay, there are various types of methods are to be used for the distributing the water. See, depending upon the topography of the town, okay, the water may be distributed by using the gravity, by pumping, or by combination of pumping and gravity, that is dual system. By using any one of the system, water is distributed to the people. Now first one is the gravity system. Okay, see, this gravity system is used when the water treatment plant is located at higher level than the supply. See here, the water treatment plant is located, or the water reservoir is at higher elevation than the supply area. Suppose this is a town and this is the supply area. If your service reservoir or water reservoir or your water treatment plant, it is at higher elevation, then we can supply the water under the action of gravity to the consumer. Okay. So see, this gravity system is, in this system, gravity force, okay, is used in distributing water from high level source to the low level zone consumer. Okay. So suppose it is the consumer or town where we have to supply the water. So under the action of gravity, that water is supplied to this consumer. Okay. See, this system eliminates pumping altogether. Okay. That's why this system becomes economical, reliable, and require less maintenance. See, for proper working of the system, the difference of head available between the service reservoir and low level zone, it should be sufficient to develop the enough pressure at the consumer time. Okay. See, this method also minimizes the wastage and leakage also. Okay. See, there are some features of this gravity system are there. This system is suitable when the source of supply is at sufficient height. Okay. Then second one is this system is more reliable, economical distribution system, because water is flow under the action of gravity. So there is no need of pumping. That's why this system becomes economical. Then the water head available at the consumer is just minimum required. Okay. This is also one of the advantage, okay, of this gravity system. Then the remaining head is consumed in the frictional and other loss. Okay. So these are the some features of the gravity system. Now next one is the pumping system. See, in pumping system, the treated water is directly pumped into the distribution main. Okay. So this system is also called as pumping without storage system. Okay. So that treated water is directly pumped into the distribution main, and that without storing in high level reservoir. So high lip pumps are provided for forcing the water into the main. Okay, see, the demand of the water is fluctuating. It is not always constant. Okay, that's why the pumps have to operate at various rates during the whole day. Okay, see, a continuous attendant is required at pumping station to regulate the flow by running only the required number of pumps out of the total number of pumps installed, because the water demand is fluctuating. Okay, see, during the failure of the pump or electric supply, the water supply to the town or to the consumer, that may be interrupted. Okay, so to avoid this, it is desirable to have some units of pump running on diesel also. See, pumping system can supply the required quantity of water for firefighting by running all the pumps, including standby also, which is not possible in the gravity system, isn't it? This system is costly because pumps are required, and that's why more electrical energy are required. That's why this system is costly, and its use should be discouraged as far as possible. Okay. Now, third type of system is that combination of gravity and pumping system. Means there are both are included. Okay. Both pumps and storage reservoir are used in this combination of gravity and pumping system. See, this combination of gravity and pumping system is used in the various cases. Like first, when the two sources of water are used to supply water, mean both gravity system and the pumping that source of water are used for the supply the water to the consumer. See here, suppose this is the city, okay, which is located in between these two. If this is source of water, so from this source we can supply the water to this city under the action of gravity. If this is second source, okay, which is having the elevation below this city, that's why pumping is required in this case. So from this second source, by pumping the water, we can supply this water from this reservoir or from this source to this city. So if such type of situations are there, so in this case we are using this combination of gravity and pumping system. See, second case is in the pump system, sometimes a storage tank is connected to the system. And third case, when the source is lower than the consumer area. Suppose if this source is here, okay, it is lower than this consumer area. Suppose city is here at higher elevation and source is at lower elevation. So in this case, pumping is required. Okay. So this is about the combination of gravity and pumping system. Okay, see, what are the advantage of this combination of gravity and pumping system? See, this system is economical, efficient and reliable, and adopted practically everywhere. Okay, pumping at constant rate increases its efficiency. Then special supervision is not required. Okay, then the fire demands can be efficiently met with. Okay, and lastly, water is available even during the failure of pump or power. So these are some advantages of this combination of gravity and pumping system. Now next important topic is the layouts of pipe network. This is very important topic, which is always asked in your exams. Okay, so dear student, give proper attention in this point. See, layouts of pipe network. See, the layout of pipeline must follow the patterns of the road. See, there are four types of system that can be usually used singularly or in combination in the required condition, like tree and dead end system, ring or circular system, grid or interlaced system, radial system. See, these distribution pipes are always laid below the roads prevailing in the town, okay, or they are also laid on the one side of the road, keeping the other side of the road for laying the sewer in future. Okay, so the layout of the pipeline naturally follow the pattern of the row. Okay, so according to that, there are, these are the four types of systems are there, okay, and which are to be used for supply the water. This tree end system, tree or dead end system, ring or circular system, grid or interlaced system, and radial system. Now we are discuss one by one in detail. See, first one is the tree or dead end system. See, in tree or dead end system, the layout of pipeline resemble the nature of tree. Okay, that's why this name is called, that system is called as the tree system. Okay, see, in this system, what happened? There is one main pipeline. Okay, see, here is the one main pipeline is there. Okay, from which number of submains are taken out according to the number of road. See, this number of these main pipelines are there, and these are the number of submains are there. Okay, this M stand for the main pipe. Okay, B stand for the branches, and S stand for the submain. Okay, so here this is the main pipeline. Okay, one main pipeline, and there are number of submains are taken to from this main pipeline. Okay, according to the number of road. Okay, see, from each submain there are number of branches are there from this submain. See here in this figure, from this submain there are, these are the number of branches are there. Okay, these are the branches are there. Okay, so number of branches are lies are taken out. From each branch lateral feeder is taken out, and from where service connection are given to the consumer. Okay, see, branch lines are sometimes used for giving the service connection, and water flows from main line to the submain and then the branches. See, the water does flow only in one direction through the all pipeline till it comes to the dead end, isn't it? Therefore, this system is called as dead end system. Okay, see, where this system is suitable. This system is suitable for the old town which are having the unplanned road, and localities having uncontrolled growth. So in such place we have to provide this tree or dead end system. So see, what are the advantages of this system? The cost of construction is low. Okay, as the number of walls are less, the determination of pressure and discharge is easy in this case. Okay, see, for controlling flow of water, the number of sluice wall required less. Okay, and the diameter and length of the feeder pipe required is small, as this service is used for the restricted population. And the disadvantage of this system is what? See, as the system distribution system develop for an unplanned settlement, there are 10% of dead end which are create stagnation of water. This is main problem. Okay, and water, see, due to the numerous dead end, water does not have free circulation. Okay, and which may lead to contamination. So these are the disadvantage of this tree or dead end system. Now next one is the ring or circular system. See, this ring or circular system, okay, in this system is also useful for the settlement which is planned. Okay, in this system, what happened? The supply of main line is laid all along the peripheral load. This is the main pipeline. Okay, so main is laid along the peripheral of the road, and the submain branches out from this main. Okay, so depending upon the pattern of the road, the closed ring may be circular or rectangular, and the discharge is divided into two parts, each going along the boundary including the area in the zone, and meet again the other end. See, the cross pipes connecting to the two main from the submain. Okay, this system is suitable, okay, for the town which are having the well-planned road crossing one another at right angle. isn't it? See, as shown in figure, okay? What are these main pipes are there that are placed along the peripheral of the rod, and in between that sub mains are to be provided. Okay, see what are the advantages of this method. First advantage is that the water is reaches at the particular point from the two roads or direction, then water is available from all direction for extinguishing fire. Okay, then during the repair, water supply can be made from other sub main. Okay, and the designing of the pipe, okay, is simple and easy. These are the advantage of this ring or circular system. And the disadvantage is that this system is costly to construct and it require more length of pipe and more number of sluice wall. Now third system is the grid or interlaced system. See, this system is also known as reticulation system. Okay, see what happened in this system. The mains and sub main and branches are interconnected. Okay, this main, sub main, okay, these are interconnected, and in well planned city, growth of the town is allowed to take place in predetermined manner. Okay, see, this is an improved system of distribution as there are no dead end and so no chance of stagnation of water. All the endpoints are connected to the main in this system. Okay, see, this system is provided in Chandigarh in Punjab. Okay, therefore this system is recommended for well planned town, isn't it? Chandigarh is first city, it is well planned city in our country. See, what are the advantages of this grid or interlaced system? See, in this system there is no dead end, so there is free circulation of water. Okay, head loss is minimum in this system. For firefighting, water is available from all direction. During the breakdowns, water supply can be made from other submain. So these are the advantages of this grid or interlaced system. And the disadvantage is that this system require more walls and longer pipe, so that this system become costly. Okay, and the calculation of diameter of pipe and pressure at point is not easy in this grid or interlaced system. Okay, and the last system in the, that is the radial system. See, in this system the total area is divided into different zone. Okay, and this system consists of laying pipeline radially. That's why this system is called as the radial system. Okay, so ending at the periphery of the area at the zone. So in each zone, what happened? Elevated service reservoir is placed at its center. So we have to make number of zone in this radial system, and at each zone the ESR is, elevated service reservoir, is to be placed at the center. Okay, and from water where this admitted to this radially laid pipeline, which are to be known as the sub branches. Okay, which are as shown in figure. Okay, see, water is pumped into this reservoir through the main and water is withdrawn through radially laid pipes. Okay, for consumer during the supply hour. So what are the advantages of this system? See, it make a quick supply of water to each house in all the zone. Okay, water is supplied to the consumer with high pressure. Calculation of the size of the pipe is easy in this case. Okay, and the development zone help to have enough and regular water supply to each zone. So these are the advantages of this radial system. But the disadvantage is that, see, at every zone require a separate service reservoir. Number of reservoir required are more, and that's why this system become costly. Okay, well, in each zone we have to construct the reservoir, ESR. That's why this system become costly. Now next point is the water supply system. See, there are mainly two types of water supply system is there. First one is the continuous system and second one is the intermittent system. See, continuous system means what? In continuous system, water is supplied or available throughout the day, that is 24 hours without any break. Okay? So, when the water is available for distribution is in abundance, okay, sufficient quantity of water is available. So, at that time, this continuous water supply system is used. See, this system is ideal because water is not remaining stagnant at any time in the pipeline and the fresh water is always available to the people. Second system is the intermittent system. See, in intermittent system, water is supplied to the public during the some fixed hour. Okay? Some fixed hours of the day. Hence, this supply is said to be intermittent. For example, 2 to 3 hours in the morning or 2 to 3 hours in the evening. That's why supply is intermittent. Okay? See, generally, in the intermittent supply system, water is supplied 3 to 4 hours in morning or in evening. So, this system is required to be adopted when sufficient quantity of water is not available or when sufficient pressure cannot be maintained in the system. So, see, under such circumstances, various zones in the town are supplied with the water by rotation. That's why this system is most widely used in our India. Okay, in our Nasik city also, okay, this intermittent system is used, not continuous water supply system. Now next point is the comparison between continuous and intermittent system. See, in continuous system, there is no need of stores to water, but in intermittent system, storage of water is required, okay, and there is chances of pollution of water, but in continuous system, there is no chance of water pollution. Second point, in continuous system, for firefighting, water is available at any time of day, but in intermittent system, during non-supply hour, water is not available for firefighting purpose, isn't it? In continuous system, small size pipes can be used for water supply, but in intermittent system, large pipes are needed to supply the water, okay, because in limited period of time is there. Then in continuous system, water remains fresh. In intermittent system, through the leaky joint or crack, water may get contaminated during the non-supply hour. Then in continuous system, the operational staff required is less number, but in intermittent system, more operational staff is required. Continuous system, more wastage of water due to its free use. Okay, there is more wastage of water is takes place in continuous system, but in intermittent system, less wastage of water due to controlled use of water. So this is the difference between the continuous system and intermittent water supply system. Now next point is the storage reservoir, or we can also call it as the service reservoir. See, what is meant by storage reservoir or service reservoir? See, the reservoir which is generally provided in distribution system to store the clear treated water before it is dispatched to the consumer. Such type of reservoir is called a storage reservoir or service reservoir. Okay. See, storage reservoirs are used to meet the fluctuating demand, to accommodate firefighting and emergency requirement, and equalize operating pressure. For that purpose, these storage reservoirs are used. Okay. See, what are the advantages of this storage reservoir? See, pump can be operated at uniform speed. Then the fluctuation in demand and supply can be balanced due to the storage reservoir. Then water can be supplied during the emergency. constant pressure can be maintained, okay, in main pipeline, okay, and the distribution mains of smaller size can be used. So these are the advantages or function of the storage reservoir. See, this storage reservoir, locate reservoir and storage to maximize benefit. Okay. Now see, classification of this storage reservoir. See, there are various types of reservoirs are there. They are classified first according to the position. They are classified as surface reservoir and, or we can also call it as ground level reservoir. And second type is the elevated storage tank. According to the shape of the storage reservoir, they are classified as circular or rectangular. According to the material of construction, the storage reservoir can be classified as steel storage reservoir or iron storage reservoir or masonry or pre-stressed concrete reservoir. So in this way, these reservoirs are classified. Now we are discussed one by one in detail. See, surface reservoir or ground storage reservoir. See, surface reservoir or ground storage reservoir, as the name indicates, this reservoir which are to be constructed at the ground level, they are known as surface reservoir. Okay, so these reservoirs are constructed at either at ground level or below the ground level, and therefore this reservoir known as the ground reservoir. See, they are rectangular or circular in shape and they can be made up of masonry or concrete. See, to control the leakage of the water from the reservoir, the inside surface are lined with the granite, concrete, asphalt or asphaltic membrane. See, this surface reservoir sometime built underground when they are large and garden is developed on their top. Okay, see, one such type hanging garden is existing in Mumbai city also. Okay, so this is about the surface reservoir. Okay, now next one is the elevated service reservoir. Okay, see, what do you mean by elevated service reservoir? The reservoirs which are constructed at an elevation from the ground level, they are known as elevated service reservoir. See, what is the function of elevated service reservoir? See, elevated tanks or reservoirs are constructed to supply the water under the action of gravity. See, they also balance the fluctuation in the demand and supply of the water. During the emergency, that ESR can supply the water. See, there are various shape of this elevated service reservoirs are there, like rectangle RCC cylindrical tank. Okay, second is the rectangular steel tank. This is the conical tank, circular tank ESR, and egg shape tank ESR. So these are the various shapes of the elevated service reservoir. Okay, thank you student. I hope that all of you understand this water distribution system very well. Okay, see, in this lecture we are discuss about the introduction of the water distribution system. Okay, then the requirement of water distribution system, objectives of the water distribution system. Okay, the component which are to be required for the water distribution system. Okay, then the systems of water distribution like gravity system, pumping system, combination of that gravity and pumping system. Okay, then the methods of water distribution. There are various methods we are discussed, like dead end system, tree, or we can call it as tree end tree system, grid iron system, circular ring system, radial system. Okay, then the water supply system, continuous and intermittent. I hope that all of you understand this topic very well. If you have any doubt, any question, any difficulty regarding this topic, you can ask me frankly. Thank you student, thank you so much.